Hello guys, my name is Nastya. Today I will brew a homebrewed beer called the Belgian Saison. It is an ale beer originally brewed in Wallonia, the French-speaking part of Belgium. In older times, Saison was brewed in order to be consumed by farmers later during the season of work in the fields. Can you guess why farmers used to drink light beer but not simply a water? Since the water quality was not very good, Saison was perfect source of hydration. This beer was even given to children. Imagine that you have a cooler in your office with a local light beer that you drink to refresh yourself during your working day. It is an awesome idea. Share it with your boss. Initially, it was a beer with low ABV around 3%, so that you could drink it, refresh yourself, and at the same time remain in working condition. But then there were stronger versions of Saison available in taverns. It was originally a farmhouse beer that was brewed in cooler months when it wasn't too hot outside, with ingredients available from local farms. Each farmhouse brewer used his own recipe. The most famous modern Saison is produced by the DuPont Brewery, which first brewed in the 1920s, and the first thing that differs from original Saison is a high level of ABV, something around 6.5%. Today I will brew a modern Saison from the ingredients that I managed to find in brewery stores in Moscow. I have already brewed beer according to this recipe, and on my Russian YouTube channel I already have a video with this recipe and a tasting. But it is in Russian, and most of the population of the earth don't understand what I'm doing there. All my friends really like this beer. It turned out to be very balanced, soft, spicy, refreshing and aromatic. This is a beer you really want to have during hot summer days. So I decided to please my friends and myself and to brew it again. Before I start brewing, I want to tell you something. Last time I brew a NEIPA beer, and I would like to share with you my thoughts that I got as a result. Here it is. Let's fill a glass. Just have a look at the color. It is hazy and looks like an orange juice in a glass. If we are talking about a smell, I definitely distinguish a citrus in it due to a sense of passion fruit, and what is interesting compared to my previous NEIPA, this one has a smell of wild strawberries in it. I love it. As always, smell of this beer is so vivid. So if one haven't tried this beer before, we'll never guess what kind of a drink is in a glass. Let's talk about the flavor. As always, it has slight bitterness, good carbonation, nice color, fruity, juicy. It is nice, fresh, and your friends will definitely like it. Today is cloudy and I'm afraid that color will not be vibrant on camera. Let's check the ABV. The refractometer shows 7.2. The original gravity was 14.8. It turns out that we have 6.3 ABV. In this brewing, I will use 5 types of malt: Pilsner, wheat, Munich, Viena, and Caramunich type 2. For hopping, I will use Yeasts, Goldings, and Fuggle. I will add ground coriander to the boil as well. To ferment this beer, I will use a special Saison yeast strain. But before I start brewing, I will ask you to like this video and subscribe to my channel, not to miss my new videos. In this brewing, we will have two temperature steps. First, 68 Celsius for 1 hour. Second, mash out on 78 Celsius for 5 minutes. Sparging afterwards and then boiling for 1 hour. Poured in a water and crushed grain in the brewery, and now we are waiting for mash out. Do not forget to stir up the mash every 20 minutes. I do the sparging without haste, trying to wash off all the sugar remain in the grain. I will hop the wort twice, once as soon as it boils, and the second time 5 minutes before the end of the boil. I will also pour in the ground coriander 5 minutes before flame out. I will not use Irish mouse tablets or verflox. For a good drain from the brewery to the fermenter, I always settle the wort after chilling for 1 hour. To ferment this beer, I will use Mangrove Jack's French Saison yeast. There is a recommendation on the back of the package to ferment at 28 to 32 degrees. Last time I read several reviews on this strain. It was told that if you pour in this yeast in the wort with a temperature of less than 25 Celsius, then it may not start working. But last time I did it at a temperature of 20 to 22 degrees and everything fermented perfectly for me. So this time I will do exactly the same. The wort has almost transferred into a fermenter. Now I will pour in this yeast in a dry way, right on top of the foam. Last time I fermented beer in a plastic bucket and bottled the beer for carbonation on day 14, after which I let the beer condition for 3 weeks. This time I will ferment the beer in a conical fermenter for 10 to 11 days, after which I will drain the yeast and leave the beer to ferment for another 10 days. And then I will bottle it for carbonation and wait about 2 weeks. For carbonation I will use about 4 grams of dextrose per 0.75 liter bottle. Well, that's all for today. Thank you all for your attention. I wish you delicious beer and perfect brews. Bye bye. Нет, она наоборот.